Hello everyone and welcome to Choo. My name is Hillal. Andrew can't be with us here today because he is not feeling well. So he's taking the day off. He's going to sit this one out. But we were really excited to bring you some gameplay, so we really wanted to get started on that. So we're bringing you Call of Duty Black Ops. It became backwards compatible for the Xbox One, and we wanted to show this for you because we have the most experience playing Call of Duty than any other video game in our library. Dating all the way back to Modern Warfare, the very first one in Call of Duty 4, where Drew and I would just spend hours playing this video game. It really consumed our lives when it first came out, in a good way, because we met a lot of good people that became friends, friends we still talk to this day, even though I haven't met many or any of them face-to-face. Drew has met one, another good guy named Dave. So Dave, if you're listening, how you doing? We love you. So, I'm not a very tactical player on this game. I kind of run around, separate myself from the group, and just try to take people out one-on-one. Drew is far more tactical than I am, and that's probably because he has that experience in his background. I don't know if that really applies to video games, but I imagine it works in some way. To his advantage. He's a far better player than I am, so clearly must. You know, it's been such a long time since I played this game, I was a little worried I wouldn't get the feel of it right away, but it seems to be coming back. I prefer these older Call of Duty games to a lot of the newer ones that are coming out, especially the one coming out this year, Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, where you have a bunch of outer space stuff and science fiction-y things, especially in the last Call of Duty Black Ops, where you had super armor and you're leaping all over the place and grabbing onto the wall. And it really went from grounding it in a modern, realistic setting to being kind of goofy and out there and more like a Halo setting. Not necessarily one that takes place in any real-world scenario. Then in the new one, you have outer space happening. I think some spaceships are going in there, which is fine, I guess, if that's your sort of thing. What I fear has happened is I've just become too old for video games. I'm sitting here complaining about the future and science fiction, and I'm talking like Grandpa Hillal, because back in my day, games were realistic, not this garbage outer space nonsense. If you want outer space, you play Halo. That's how it should be, that's how it'll always be. I'm not racist against video games, I'm setting my ways. But it's clearly I'm not the demographic anymore. I'm in my, I don't know, mid to late 30s, I guess. You can say late, but it's not really late, more mid. And I still play games, but they're clearly not geared to me anymore. They're geared to a much younger generation. I've priced myself out of the market age-wise. They're not, video game companies are not concerned if they're making their dollar from me. Which is funny because they, when you look at it, they don't release video games throughout the year like you would with a movie. If you don't know where your movie should go, you have 12 months, you can figure it out. Usually if you don't feel strongly about it, you could stick it in March or August. Or if you feel really strong about it, you stick it in December or summer. But you don't have to release every movie out all at once. With video games, you either got summer or winter. You don't have any in between. So you have all these games coming out all at once. I kind of lost my train of thought. Didn't know where I was going with this one. But it's hard to get through these games, I find, because as soon as you start one and you get halfway through it, the next one comes out and you want to start that one and play it, but you never finish the one previous. And I don't know if it's just because I don't have time to play the games as much as I used to when I was younger, or if it's just the fact that I'm older, and maybe I don't want to sit in front of my TV for hours on end anymore. I'm not quite sure what it is. Is it that they all come out at once and there's no time? Or is it because I'm old? I have a feeling it's because I'm old. Because there'll be days where I'll have a vacation day from work, and I'll be, well, this is the day I play video games. And by the time I get around to it, it's like 2, 3 o'clock. It leaves me maybe 2 hours to 90 minutes to play before I have to go pick up my son from daycare. So it's not, I have every opportunity to sit from, you know, 7 in the morning to 4 in the afternoon. I just don't take advantage of that. I usually clean or run an errand. And by the time I actually get around to playing the video game, it's so late in the afternoon, it doesn't leave much time. So it's probably, do we stop playing because we go old, or do we grow old because we stop playing? So my kind of game style is, I'll usually run a ghost or silent class and separate myself from the rest of the pack so that I don't get picked out. This one, I don't think I'm running silent. I'm definitely running loud. I don't have a silencer on my gun. I'm easy to pick on the radar. But I find the accuracy is a lot better when you have the silencer. Oh, no, sorry. The bullets are more powerful when you don't have the silencer on. And that's kind of what I was going for, especially in this match. One of the first I played in, I don't know how long, 5-6 years since this first game came out. But I don't think I'm doing poorly. I'm not doing great. When it comes to Call of Duty and a lot of these first-person shooter multiplayer games, I either do fantastic or I do terrible. I'm either the top of the board or way at the bottom. Like, way, way at the bottom. Oh, God, that guy. That was good. But speaking of being priced out of the market, age-wise, since we're on that topic, I recently saw a few movies that had me feel that way as well. I saw Sausage Party, which, you know, I feel embarrassed just saying the title out loud, but it's getting a whopping 81% on Rotten Tomatoes, so I guess I'm not the only person who's at least said Sausage Party out loud in the last few weeks or months. A lot of people seem to like it. 81% Rotten Tomatoes. I didn't really care for it. I didn't think it was very funny. I think it's more of the same Seth Rogen jokes we're used to. The only Seth Rogen movies I ever found entertaining were Pineapple Express, This Is the End, and Green Hornet. Yes, I was the guy who liked Green Hornet. Liked Green Hornet, hated Sausage Party. I don't know. But a lot of, not a lot, a few people were asking me if I just had a problem, because if you're not familiar with the movie, it has a very existential, religious kind of questioning to it. I don't think it's really a religious movie, or it asks any questions that haven't been asked before. But a few people were asking me if I was turned off by it, and I really, no, I wasn't. A movie can be about anything it wants, and it can have any message it wants. I'll judge a movie on whether it's entertaining or informative, not on the subject matter at hand. That being said, I really didn't think it was a religious-based movie. I just didn't think it was very funny or well-written or creative. All the best parts were in the trailer. Every joke you laughed at is given to you 3 months ahead of time on the internet, in movie theaters, TV. So there really wasn't anything surprising in it. But again, that leads me to, is it that I'm just not the target for this movie? Am I too old to enjoy it? Probably. I don't know. It seems like a lot of immature-ish humor, which is not to say that the people who like it are immature, because my wife really liked the movie, and she has great judgment when it comes to movies and stories. I just don't... I think because of the movies I've seen in my lifetime, it's hard to shock me. So when you get, oh, this is the outrageous comedy of the summer, it better be the outrageous comedy of the summer and show me something I haven't really seen before. Now, I've never seen a movie about food starring food, but I have had toys kind of along that way. What were those toys called? Food Fighters or something like that, and you had one set, was it vegetables against, like, meat products? And I forget what it was, but you had, like, a donut in a cop uniform, a burger in army fatigues. I forget what the rest of them were, so it's not exactly a wholly original idea, Sausage Party, because Food Fighters was a toy line cartoon when I was a kid. That came out of nowhere. How did I remember Food Fighters? But whenever I feel like I'm being the old man in the room, I just think of Homer Simpson's "I'm a male, age 18 to 42. Everyone cares what I think." And that might have been true a few years ago. But the younger generation now, it's like you're old as soon as you hit 21, 22. It's very Children of the Cornish. As soon as you hit a certain age, we're sending you behind the rows. But if you look at Sausage Party, which I really didn't care for, but was getting huge numbers on Rotten Tomatoes, and then a movie like Suicide Squad, which is getting low numbers on Rotten Tomatoes, but I kind of liked it. I really didn't think it was bad. It wasn't a great movie, but there was a lot there to work with, and I really didn't mind it. I would say Jared Leto's Joker probably wasn't my favorite Joker. But that being said, I thought Suicide Squad was a fine first going. It's been number one the past 3 weeks, maybe 4 weeks now? So hopefully we'll get a sequel and we won't need the setting up. So I didn't do very well in that match. So we're going to go into firing range. I think we're joining the middle of this game. So let's see how this one goes. But yeah, I thought Suicide Squad wasn't that bad. I was actually kind of shocked to see that it was only pulling 26 on Rotten Tomatoes. Not enough to call for the boycott of Rotten Tomatoes, because Rotten Tomatoes doesn't do reviews, per se. They just kind of collect what all the critics are saying about movies. So I really don't think we need to boycott a website that collects information. If you're gonna boycott the collection of information, then it's a very weird dystopian future we're living in. But as long as I'm on the topic of the younger generation and movies, last night, my wife and I went to go see The Princess Bride for one of the Throwback Tuesdays at our local Regency. And it was kind of cool because it was definitely the most crowded of that Throwback Tuesday series we've been to in a long time. We saw a few movies so far at Throwback Tuesday, Great Outdoors, I forget what some of the other ones now are. My memory isn't all that great. But I was speaking to some people who I'm usually with on a daily basis talking about going to go see The Princess Bride, and these people are younger than I am. They're in their early to mid-20s, maybe late 20s, and when I go, "Yeah, I'm seeing The Princess Bride," they're like, "The Princess what? The Princess who?" And it's like, how do you not know what The Princess Bride is? It's this weird thing that I'm finding the younger generation has about, there's some sort of pride in not knowing or caring about the things that came before them, which is very odd, because when I was 13, I was fully aware of Star Wars and Evil Dead, and those things came out long before I was even born. And it's actually a nerd point of pride, at least for my generation or when I was in high school, to know about these sorts of things. But it seems like it's better to be kind of in the dark about the things that came before you than it is to go, "Oh, I saw that movie that came out in the 80s or 90s. I know nothing about that movie," and that's the way it should be. It's just weird. I find myself asking these questions a lot.
Alpha.
So I'm not doing great this map. It's hard because this is a domination map, and I'm trying to get this point B flag. And the impossible thing about point B, especially on this map, is that it's so completely out in the open that as soon as they hear you're taking it or stealing it or getting it for your side, the other team just comes and swarms on you, and there's really very little places to hide when you're taking that particular B flag, and that B flag is kind of notorious for being difficult to take.
We must push forward. Defeat is not acceptable.
So we'll see if I can get this one. And I know I'm gonna die. Oh no, I made it. So I tried a Drew tactic earlier where I was gonna go up to that second floor and plant a claymore. And that's what I call Drew fishing, because he's a savant with the claymore. Never works for me. I never get any kills with the claymore. Ah, see? But that wasn't B, that was A. No, that was B. Never mind. No, C. C is the one that's out there in the open. Ah. So now we're back in this map again.
We lost Alpha.
It's funny how Call of Duty will just put you in these rotations on certain maps, and they won't ever give you the one you really want to play. But it's been so long since I played this game, I really don't know what other maps there are. I forget if this is the one on the luxury liner, or if this is the one with Nuketown. I don't think it's the one with Nuketown. So it must be the one with the luxury liner. I forget what that one is called. So this one I am running silent. I have ghost and a silencer on, which means my shots aren't going to show up on radar. If they have some sort of motion detector, I won't be picked up. It doesn't really help. But it does help in my gameplay in that I don't stick, like I said earlier, with the rest of the team. I try to break myself away. Because if you get any sort of, if the other team gets any sort of helicopter bonus or mass napalm strike or anything like that, and the whole team gets it, you don't want to be around your other teammates when that's going on. So I try to get myself as far away from the other teammates as possible. And this setting helps. So you guys tell me, are you looking forward to Call of Duty Infinite Warfare? For me, the only reason to buy it is to get Modern Warfare, or Call of Duty 4, I forget what it's called, the very first Modern Warfare title. The only reason to get Infinite Warfare is because it comes with Modern Warfare, or Call of Duty 4. If Drew were here, he'd be yelling at me because I had forgotten the title again. But what do you want? That game came out 10, 11 years ago? And there's been a Call of Duty game every year since that game? That's a lot of Call of Duties to remember.
Alpha secure.
So here I am. I don't get a lot of kills. I'm really not great. But I'm persistent and I'm plucky.
Enemy spy plane above.
And usually that guy does okay in warfare, doesn't he? He always makes it home.
Securing
the plucky
B.
Sidekick. Just as long as I don't keep a picture of my girl in my wallet. See? Got that guy. Plucky wins again. Oh, never mind. So I know I'm about to die on... Oh, I could have stabbed him. I don't know why I didn't.
Enemy care package incoming.
So am I just being old man Hillal when I complain about Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, or are you as sick of kind of outer space-ish games as I am? Now, Star Wars Battlefront I'll give you, because you can't have Star Wars anywhere but outer space settings, but that's kind of the whole point of Star Wars. And speaking of which, Battlefront's not a bad game. gets a lot of flack. I'm not quite sure why. It's a good game, especially if you like Call of Duty and Star Wars, which I do.
We're being dominated. Take those positions.
It's definitely a lot more difficult than this. This is a lot more just kind of running and gunning and chaos and spray shooting. I'm sure there's a certain level of skill to it. In fact, I know there is because there's championships for, what is it, millions of dollars? Hundreds of thousands of dollars? Oh, come on. So there is a certain level of skill, but I find a game like Battlefront is a game more about skill than running around and shooting, and Call of Duty is more about running around and shooting than it is skill and tactics.
Hostile jamming our radar. Hostile jamming our radar. Losing Alpha.
So you see, I can find them, but I can't get my bullets to connect, or there's always some other guy or partner right over their shoulder screwing me over as soon as I get one kill.
Enemy spy plane above.
So see, with the spy plane above, they're not going to find me on their radar because I'm running ghost.
Enemy care package inbound.
And I got it, can't believe it.
Friendly spy plane inbound.
There we go. So
we lost C.
There he is. Got him. Nice try. Come on, come on. Oh, come on.
Securing B.
Okay. So it's really exciting to be able to bring you this footage. At first we tried recording gameplay through our laptops. Drew has a very powerful laptop. I have a Surface Pro 3, and originally we tried streaming the video through the Xbox app and using the built-in Xbox DVR. For whatever reason, we couldn't quite get that to work. I think it was a power issue as far as the Surface Pro 3 goes. I just don't think it had the memory or the computing power to do something like that. And with Drew's laptop, it was just some sort of weird connective issue that we couldn't quite figure out. So we're actually using, I can't pronounce the name of the company, it's Hauppauge or something like that. It's a device called an HPDVR. And essentially what you do is you hook your Xbox up to that, run a cord to your TV, plug in a USB from the box to your Surface Pro or your laptop, and hit record while you play. And so far, I gotta tell you, it was super easy to use. The footage, I think, looks great. It's definitely high def output. So I'm really digging this thing. I really can't wait to bring a lot more gameplay to you guys, especially when we get Drew on the blower, because as good as I am by myself, and let's face it, I'm pretty damn good, Drew and I together, it's just usually comedy gold, and at least as far as I'm concerned, I really don't bother myself about what makes other people laugh. I just try to make myself, my friends, and my family laugh. But I find when I'm talking and just shooting the crap with friends or what have you, my gameplay goes up. When I'm by myself or if I'm just kind of hopping online to find a match, I find I'm in my head a lot and my game suffers for it. So you can see I'm not really doing all that great. I'm doing okay. I'm getting some kills, but I'm dying at least once for every kill, which is not great. Now, this is a map I haven't played in a long time. And I think this is, yeah, this is my sniper map. I came in without my sniper gun. Okay, that's alright. No, it's alright, I just died. So I think, no, I'm on the wrong side of the map, but I think I can get around to the other side before they see me. I don't wanna get caught, so I'm gonna... Oh, I forgot I could hack that.
Be secure.
So if I can get around to the other side of the map, there's a water tower right here. Here we go. And hopefully no one is up here.
Losing A.
Is that guy one of us? No! No! Oh, come on. Come on. Really? Alright. So I know that guy is up on the water tower, so maybe if I get over there I can get him down.
Enemy buff inbound.
One thing that is a little bit tricky I find with the HPDVR is the audio. We've been having to wrestle kind of just to figure out the audio. It's no through no fault of the box. I'm just kind of half-witted when it comes to the recording of audio. I worry so much about the video, I forget to worry about what it's going to sound like or what tracks there's going to be. But I think it'll be better in the future, and I'm going to try to get this guy. I know he's over there, but I don't see him. Maybe he left. There's a guy in there. Guy there, but I can't get him. Now he knows I'm here, so I'm running. No. Oh. We'll do some Drew fishing. We'll let him know I'm here. Maybe I'll bait some of them to come trip the Claymore. Oh, it's one of ours. Okay. Well, we can get this together.
Die.
Come on.
Losing C.
No, we're not losing C. Eat my grenade. Got you. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh.
We lost C.
All right, I'm gonna try again. Where are you?
Securing Alpha.
Nice try. I can see your Claymore. So I want to get out of here. He knows I'm here.
Enemy spy plane above.
And that kind of sounds like the we're about to lose music. Oh, got you! Oh, come on.
Our spy plane's in the air. Securing Charlie.
Come on. Got it. So what's recently? We just both got the new sequel to the Deus Ex series, so we can't wait to bring you some of that gameplay. Come on. Our Battlefield gameplay is really good. I think that's really funny, so we're going to be bringing you some of that. There's so much stuff. I'm so happy that I live in this day and age where technology is so readily available that we can bring you stuff like this. So I really hope you stick around. I really hope you like and subscribe to our channel, because I think we got some good stuff here. And I really hope you find it entertaining. We think it's entertaining, and we're kind of taking the chance to hope... Oh, come on. We're kind of taking the chance to hope that you guys do too.
Securing Charlie.
Got you. Surprise. Oh, no, no. Got him.
Enemy spy plane above.
And oh no. Oh, come on.
Enemy Cobra headed your way. Enemy Napalm strike incoming.
Come on.
Losing A.
It's funny, when I get shot or killed, I look at my remote like it was the remote's problem.
We're being dominated. Take those positions.
Ah, come on.
Never forget this defeat.
Well, that's it for this recording. I really hope you had a good time watching me play. My name is Hillal. This is Choo Entertainment on YouTube. If you like the video, please like it and subscribe to our channel. Give us a thumbs up and leave us a comment. Let us know you're watching. And thanks for paying attention to me and my ranting. We'll see you soon. Bye.